Yeah, the superintendent is pushing a complaint. He's hoping to force the state to change the way it distributes education funding. And he is reaching out to the top, naming the governor himself in the complaint.
Superintendent Lawrence Spring has named the governor, the legislature, the education department, and the education commissioner in that complaint. The claim he makes before the Department of Justice is schools with mostly white students tend to get a higher percentage of state funding than schools that are comprised of mostly minority students. Spring wants a full investigation by the Justice Department. He also wants the government to declare New York State is violating the Civil Rights Act and order the state to provide sufficient resources for schools. Craig Smith joins us with a look at what happens next and who's feeling the impact.
Well, Jerry, the superintendent's been letting parents know if they sign on to this complaint, it's possible a federal investigator may interview them about this. Parents say what's happening isn't fair, and they say it's hurting their kids.
Jamaica Miles says when she picks up her son, she thinks about stories from teachers and other parents.
Just today, I found out that there's a math teacher that has 30 students and only 17 textbooks. How is that even a reality?
She says it was school superintendent Lawrence Spring who made her aware her son's school isn't all it could be and encouraged parents to help do something about it.
You know, it has to be a complaint. You know, it's de facto discrimination, I believe.
According to the complaint, the formula that sprang from the Campaign for Fiscal Equity several years ago has not been properly followed. Spring says it has cost his district as much as $64 million a year. He says schools that received more funding than required were allowed to keep it, with the idea more money would come to other schools later.
In that process of leveling them up, they had an economic recession, froze districts, and then actually reversed that leveling up and took money away from them.
Spring says if the Department of Justice could force New York State to share its funding fairly, it might mean more than just 40% of students would be reading at their grade level. And he says property taxes would drop by one-third. Jamaica Miles believes it could mean a big difference, and not only for her two children.
Some people say, oh, well, Hamilton Hill, yeah, that's where everyone lives that, you know, is impoverished and they need more help. In our school district, more than 90% of our students are eligible for free and reduced lunch. That's not just the Hamilton Hill area.
The state has to make this right for, you know, for school districts that are minorities majority. It can't continue this way.
The district says it's closer to 80% qualifying for the lunch program. Spring says he's not asking for the state to make up for lost funding, only to reform its distribution. He hopes to meet with the U.S. attorney sometime next week. Jerry, Liz?
Well, you know, Craig, question for you. I know he names the governor. Does the governor have any response?
No comment from the governor's office tonight. A spokesman did say only that the state tried to address some of these concerns in the latest budget. Jerry.
All right, Craig, thank you for that report.
Okay.
Well, members of the New York State